Oh yeah, I forgot I was going to hit that. 120 attack! Welcome back to the Hardcore Road to Insane Final Boss. So that's 120 all combat skills, which is cool. Just here training up my refined anima core legs of Zeros. And I have to do this like 6 times to get 6 times 4, which is 24 Elegenkin components. So that'll be nice, but yeah, it's just going to take a while. Well, that was a good day of full raids. Did like 10 full raids in a row in one day because Shadow was hunting the Akamaru pet and he got it at 231 kills, so I'm guessing no more today, but that's a good 10% more of the way towards 100 KC for that final boss requirement. And these are the types of teams you really want to look out for when you're trying to get KC or pet grinding. Just grinding it out off loot is just the best way to get the pets and the kill count requirements out of the way. A day or two later, I joined a team with people just camping Yakka for the KC and the pet chance, but for whatever reason, instead of camping Yakka that much, we decided to do like every single raid feat for the Daredevil title. So here we are unlocking the Daredevil title, I guess. And because I'm a washed up bad YouTuber, I didn't record us doing any of the Yakka feats, but just take my word for it, I guess. It was pretty smooth sailing. I only signed like once during one of the All Together Now attempts, and that's not that spooky with a Ring of Death as a backup. Alright, here we are back at ED1. I have a pretty terrible history with this boss. It took Pub Stomp 276 kills to get this pet, which is by far the most kills it has ever taken me to get a pet from an elite dungeon. And then of course, this is the boss that killed me for the first and only time so far in this account. That was a while ago. I think it's high time to get my revenge on Siriu the Azure Serpent. By the way, don't flame me for how I pronounce Siriu. Like, nobody knows how you're supposed to pronounce it.
Siriu.
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 Runs through the dungeon are usually about 16 minutes, so I activate my aura at the Sanctum Guardian and I can get a full 4 runs in 1 hour. There are a lot of spooky mechanics throughout the dungeon. All 3 bosses can hit like a truck if you're not careful. And even some of the little mobs in the dungeon have some really deadly special attacks. I've signed like twice already to an unexpected Die by the Blade special attack. It's also worth mentioning Siriu has some of the most punishing mechanics out of any boss if you don't move out of the way, so any disconnection or a client crash during that fight is basically a guaranteed death. As we've seen before, those tendrils can also be pretty darn sneaky about hitting 4Ks every tick. Last chance to get this pet before 100 KC and it's 14 ancient scales, no pet. And you don't get like the pop-up for Siriu, but you get the little green message there. Like, you get the pop-up for doing Masuda KC, but for whatever reason, when you unlock the achievements for a kill count at Siriu, it's, I think it's bugged or something. But yeah, so that means for final boss, it's just basically Yakamaru left. I have like 10 mole kills I need to do, so I want to save that for last just so I can unlock final boss title at Mole again on this account, because I did that on Pub Stomp. That was just funny. But yeah, 100 Siriu, and who knows how long it's going to be till I get the pet, but now I'm just locked in until I get the pet. Ugh, fun times. Oh wow, that was a doubled Masuda's War Spear, which is interesting, I guess. Man, nothing interesting really happens in this dungeon. I'm about to hit the second threshold at 120 KC, so that'll be nice to have a 1 in 100 drop rate instead of a 1 in 150. It's like a 33% increase. But man, I just hope that I get this pet so I can be put out of my misery and be done with this place. Even better than two Masuda's War Spirits is two fishy treats! That's two Sanctum Guardians I don't have to do in the next two runs. Oh, that's 180 kills at Sirius. That's the third threshold? Should be 400 and 300 drop right now, if that makes a difference. Come on, let's see a nice clean 200 KLC broadcast. Nope. That's 200 kills at 81 and no pet. We've been here twice as long as we would have had to if I'd gotten the pet under 100 KC, but guess we go back and hope for the 1 in 75 pet drop chance at this point. It's ridiculous. Got a Masuda's War Spear this kill as well, and 111 Dungeoneering. Like, all these Dungeoneering levels past 99 have been all from Elite Dungeon runs, which is kind of ridiculous. Here's loot from 281 runs, I guess. 16 Masuda's War Spear, over 1,000 uncommon Relic of Anime Shees. One of each weapon upgrade kit, which is nice. But let's keep going. Good god, is that a doubled Sirius Claw? Come on, man. I've got so many of those now. And here it comes, 240 kills at Sirius. That's threshold number 4? I'm starting to think this boss just hates me, and believe me, the feeling is mutual. Whoa, that's the most scales I've gotten in a drop. 192 ancient scales? That's almost the max you can get. Was really hoping not to have to record this clip, but here we are at threshold number 6, at 360 kills. Drop rate should be 1 in 42.8 or so at this point, so I guess see ya in the next 60 kills when we don't get it and have to record at 420. Blaze it. Yes, there it is, finally, 382 kills to get the stupid chipped black dragon, chick black stone drop it, 380 kills, 382 solos through this stupid dungeon. It's in the chest, it's not showing up on the ground, it's just double checking the chest just to be safe. Also want to get a feather out of the bank so I can torture this stupid dragon. Anyway, I don't even know what to say, I know there's a few things I wanted to say, but I can't remember them, which is so annoying because it's been so long that I've been at this boss. This is why there's the magic of editing.
You did it!
Can't find feathers in the bank. There they are. Okay, one feather, and then check the chest. Chip black stone crystal, there it is. 6.2 bill in this chest. I guess, yeah, let's just take a look at loot from 381 runs, because they did one kill for the Reaper title or something. Almost 2,000 uncommon relics, over 11,000 common relics, lots of alks, 16 mil pure cash, a bunch of potions, 135k chimes, and 100 taijutsu. Those are going to be awesome if I ever go for the salty title in this account, just free progress towards the salty title. 10 Sirius Claws, double digits of that super rare drop from just running the dungeon. 23 Masuda's War Spears, the fishy treats I used as I got them, so you're not going to see those in this chest. 4 Sea Singer weapon upgrade kits, 3 Tetsu upgrade kits, 49 rare relics, you have to disassemble those, hope for some Illajankan components. And then, of course, the big value item, Ancient Scales. These are like a mil each or something, right? On the GE? Yeah, 1 mil each on the GE. So that's 5.6 bill in that alone. So, I don't know. I know I'm not going to use all those in this account, because like I'm just going to make one set of the ranged armor for like 840 of them. And then the rest, I guess maybe drop trade? At least keep some on the account to do repairs. But like I'm not going to need 5,000 ancient scales for repairs. Okay, let's tickle this dragon. This dungeon, doing this dungeon so much, made me want to play Sekiro so much. And not just because it's got the same vibes as this dungeon, like with just like similar inspiration and themes of that like cultural stuff, but because near the end of Sekiro, you fight this big divine dragon, and in that fight, you stab it in the eye and harvest some of its tears. And I've been wanting to do that to this stupid dragon for so long, for everything this dragon has put me through in this account. 276 kills on Pub Stomp to get the pet, 382 kills to get this on this account, and it's the one boss that has killed me on this account, Yeah, I'm having some hard feelings with this boss. Oh, and here we go, banking this entire chest. I should have plenty of space in my bank since I cleared out all of my archaeology relics I was just never going to use. So I cleared up like 80 bank spaces or something ridiculous. But let's go ahead and click and drag chipped black stone crystal into the pet tab, which means I'm done with all the elite dungeon pets. Those are some of the worst pets to go for on going for IFB. The dungeons just take so long and the pets 1 in 300. So there we go, there's the Humming Blackstone Crystal from 82 way back then, the Umbral Urn from 83, and now finally the Chip Blackstone Crystal from 81. And of course that's the drop log complete, obviously. Like, this drop log is one of the easiest to complete except for the pet. You just need like one war spear, one fishy treat, and then the pet. 25 fishy treats. They actually overtook Masuda's war spears, even though like at one point it was like 10 fishy treats to 20 war spears or something. So they really caught up when it got like a couple of double fishy treat drops. Oh man, my disassembly machine and my alk machine and my invention guild is gonna have its work cut out for it. Just disassembling and alking all this crap. Let's go ahead and disassemble the 49 rare relics and convert Chimes and Taijutsu to the currency pouch. So that's gonna be like a huge chunk of the salty grind done. There's a bunch of other requirements, but it'd be really nice to not have to worry about Chimes or Taijutsu. Those are some of the worst parts of that grind. Hey, there's an Illajinkan component. Heck yeah, let's hope for more. Ooh, a second Illajinkan component. Nice, towards the end. Can we fit in one more? Nope. I guess I'll take two Illajinkan components from 49 rare relics up to 27 after disassembling pretty much everything from that God Wars Dungeon 2 grind. Yeah, that'll be hopefully enough for at least one more Aftershock 4 Equilibrium 2, right? Oh man, all those relics can't even fit inside the disassembler for the common and uncommon relics. I was also going to mention, this took a lot of supplies. Like 382 ED1 runs. I use like 7 vulnerability bombs per run. There's overloads, weapon poison. Runes was a big cost on this. I had to make like blood runes with rune crafting a few times, a couple hours of just doing blood rune crafting because I ran out, like 14k left. But yeah, that is worth mentioning because that's almost like 2,000 plus vulnerability bombs for one boss, which is not ideal. Might have to make some more of those. Ugh, not to mention all the charges. Using Crypt Bloom, you use a lot of charges in an elite dungeon, so gonna have to replenish those. But so nice to have this done. I got my revenge on this boss, finally, after all this time. Yeah, just got a mass capability codex in that raid, and it feels good to reattune this ED1 portal to Telos. Let's go for the Telos pet next. I've got 12 minutes of Manny left. Surely I can get it after my like 1400 kills dry so far. Oh yeah, one more thing I'm getting out of ED1. I'm finally making the tier 92 ranged armor, which I think I've got everything I need for it in my inventory. Just start with making the Serenic Mask, upgrading it to the Elite Serenic Mask. Man, how do I do this? Alright, I need Prazolic Essence. I know I have enough Prazolic Essence range because I've had these 4 Pernix bodies just sitting in my bank forever since I did like the next grind for the Torva, for like the Masterwork stuff. Okay, this time's for real. Craft Elite Serenic Mask, and then I'll be crafting the body and legs. Now I'm out of Algarum thread because I didn't buy enough. Completely forgot you had to use Algarum thread to upgrade it as well as make the new new base Serenix. So yeah, I gotta buy like 6 more of that. There's the Elite Serenic chaps, and then finally the Elite Serenic hauberk. What am I missing? Chaotic spikes. God, there's always more. Although yeah, that was one other thing I forgot to mention about the ED1 grind. Look how many freaking Dungeoneering tokens I got! 6.6 million Dungeoneering tokens! That's all from that Elite Dungeon grind. So this is gonna be used towards 120 Dungeoneering. When I've got like nothing better to do, I'll be starting to work on just Dungeoneering and other comp cape requirements, I guess. And yeah, those tokens are gonna be super helpful for buying like cards to card all the floors and warps and things like that. Just to make that 120 Dungeoneering grind super quick. Can't believe you have to buy the Chaotic Spikes one at a time. This is so inconvenient. Okay, this time for real. Craft Elite Serenic Hauberk, There we go. The only real bummer to that was both the top and legs were level 20 when I disassembled them, so I know you can upgrade them, like, while they're still regular and augmented, but then I would have had to recharge it with, like, repair patches instead of just making a new one, so just had it against that. But there is an augmented Elite Serenic Hauberk, and then finally, the augmented Elite Serenic Chaps. Ugh, finally. Been wanting to make these because I'm going to be using it at Nex. Nex is one of the bosses I want to get done, probably after Telos, just because I want that Telos pet. But anyway, that's where I think I'm going to end this episode. Got that full tier 92 ranged gear, and I'm working on the Encando hatchet grind. Like, I've got 3 out of the 4 pieces so far after just a few hours. The superior tree shaking scrimshaw making this kind of easy. So yeah, should be almost done there. And then it's on to Telos and Nex and other bosses that I've been just waiting to finish 81 to go back to. So nice to have 81 done. Anyway, thanks for watching and see you next time.